Hallelujah, hallelujah. All of us want to know you, Mama Ruach. Man calls you a he, for they would never give credit to you in the past. Holy, 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 holy. We just call upon you, Mama Ruach HaKodesh. Won't you please reveal yourself to me? Won't you reveal yourself to us? You can give a vision to my husband just as well as you can give it to me. You can anoint him to know these things just as well as you can me. Kathy has beautiful writings that I know that you are writing through her in a whole different tone of voice. You're so gentle. You're everything a woman should be. As a woman, my desire is to be more like you. You're the definition of the word feminine. Even Abba Yehovah and Yahushua warn, don't hurt you.
Wait. Now is not yet the time for me to reveal in the way that you have asked me to reveal. But I shall do it, and you shall teach it, and the lies shall be combated. It is I that gives the desire to say this prayer. It is I that gives the desire to know who I am. For it is I who you did lay your head upon the shoulder in heaven. I gave you a glimpse to see how much those who love Yahushua are loved by me. I am the mother of creation. Females were made in my image. I am ageless. I am co-creator. The family is a copy of what is in heaven. Where do you think it came from? The mother, the father, and the children. This doesn't mean in heaven birth is as it is here on earth. It was never meant to be so. It was because of Eve's sin and Adam's sin it became a painful process. There is no discord in heaven. There is no pain in heaven. There is only love and peace and joy. There is only happiness.
What else, Mama? What else do you want to tell me?
Elisabeth, you who have craved for the love of a mother since you were conceived, even in your mother's womb you cried out to me. This is why I fill you now in the way that I do with such a unique anointing between you two, so you will never feel that void again. Nico, you were starved for attention. Your earthly mother did the best she could with the spirit that she was working with. But I too fill you with my love. Elisabeth, when you rock and you pray, it is me that rocks you. Keep striving to know who I am. I will reveal more to you. I will bring you remembrance of what it was like in heaven when you beheld my face. For I sit next to your heavenly Father. Yahweh is my husband. Yahushua is my son. There is not only one throne. There are three thrones in heaven, and we rule in unison. How do you think your prayers reach your Abba Yahweh's ears? It is I that sends them to him, for I am in the believers, those who love my son Yahushua. It is I, the anointed wind, that blows them to him as I blow a kiss to heaven. I speak in symbolism so you can understand. When you lift up prayer, it is like blowing kisses to your Abba Yahweh. When you pray in my son's name, for it takes all three of us for you to be heard and answered. This is just the beginning of the teaching. It is only for those who I tell you to tell. Of course, all of this family you will share this with. But I will move you with caution, unlike any other words spoken. For these are secrets Satan never wanted revealed, and he will fight you with a fight like you have never encountered before. That is why it is not yet time to give the word to the world. I will speak to you in things no man or woman has heard. Why do you think Lucifer came and tempted Eve first? It was to mock me, for Eve was made in my image, as Adam was made in Yahweh's image, as Abel was made in Yahashua's image. Righteousness. The definition of love. So it is by Satan's hand Cain slew Abel, just as it was by the spirit of Cain's hand again Satan used to crucify my son Yahashua, although it was part of all our plan for those of you whose names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life, to heaven you could return. There was no other way. So a new blood covenant was birthed that day to replace the old blood covenant that could not stand. You want to know one of the things that grieves me? Do you want to know one of the things that offends me? Elisabeth, when you feel my anger and my rage, they speak of the Father's rage, of Abba Yahweh's rage. You do not have a clue of the rage of the Mother of Creation. You just have a fraction of my rage. When you feel that volcano ready to blow inside of your head, and it's in the name of righteousness, you just have a fraction of my rage. When you read in the word that's been translated, and they dare to call my son Yahashua the son of man. He was never the son of a man. He is the son of Yahweh, the son of Yah. When you read this in the translation, for how long now have I caused you to grieve, and you have never felt peace in this, and yet you explain, all the translations do this. It was not by my hand. This is by Satan's plan. Although he was born in a human frame, although he suffered on the cross the pain, he was never, never, never the son of man. He is the son of Yah, and his name even to the world proclaimed. Why do you think Satan in the translation tried to regulate him and give him the name of a man? I've had to allow this, and at this time, before the great tribulation, the name of Jesus will stand. Oh, but in the great tribulation, those who are saved now and have been living holy before me, my spirit is within them. Just as you were saved in the name of Jesus, you'd still be calling upon him in that name. And do not misunderstand me. There is power, heavenly power, to back up that name because of the mercy of your Abba Yahweh.